send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Godden and Joel Davis.
The oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the Green Bay Packers. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Charles, we look at this Packer team as we enter play here. It's an early test here after two losses to start the season and a game they probably really need.
Obviously, no way do they want to get to 0-3. Not many teams make the playoffs with that kind of a start.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Rams, they come in at an early crossroads here, facing a tough opponent on the road where a loss would make them 0-3.
And when you start that way, doubts really start to creep into the locker room, and guys start to battle each other instead of worrying about winning games.
This is taken at its full. And we'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line.
That's a long day trying to prepare for Todd Gurley.
Here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
The clock's running down. They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. Not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now, saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
Second down. To the sideline, and it's caught. But boy, he
Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Now this is blocked. And the Rams have got it. But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
Well, there's a blocked extra point. I remember playing and we had one of those go against us. I remember our kicker and our holder told the head coach, just relax, coach. Why are you yelling? Don't worry, it's just one point. Those coaches see a point is gold to them because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's why I was just going to say first quarter. We'll see if this has any implications as the game goes on.
I still can't believe they told the head coach to relax.
Bad move. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Los Angeles. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically, what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
And it pushes way forward to about the 32. The numbers on the ground for Gurley. To the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field.
Set, 3-19, 3-19,
short one here, complete to his tight end. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Franks to add the PAT. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in three plays. And the result, a Green Bay score. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over.
And this is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to attain.
Todd Gurley, wave goodbye. 20-10. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Todd Gurley, his second touchdown on the season. And the Rams strike quickly for 6 points. And with his speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage up front? Offensive line out-leveraging the defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's going to be very difficult to catch and corral.
And that'll make it 13-7. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper into the end zone for the touchdown. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Expecting a run here.
Bob, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, something in the air, deep ball. But Bob just taking it. Big time jaunt. Now, if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
And we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. And that's the
their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. First set of downs here. Second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Rams with a football to get us going. But they face a second and long to start things out.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39! Watch it now, Barney! Barney! All right, now look at
gun, gun! Gun, gun!
On the gun.
Sometimes those cliches really come true, don't they? When it takes all 11 to play good defense, we've seen that in this ball game. I think the secondary has to be singled out, though. They are in the presence of every receiver whenever the ball is thrown, and this one they have forced another incompletion.
Second down. Second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And able to inside the 15 to the 13. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Boy, what would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Under four to go now as the clock runs, and they come
Let's
up
go.
On second down. Second down, this is good. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Now Gurley staying down. Let's hope he's all right. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. This will be the 9th play on this drive. Completion, but they'll still be faced now with a third and goal situation.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
This offense so far on third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and goal. Touchdown on the season, and the Rams are able to get back within a touchdown. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And they'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And our focus now moves to Randall Cobb. The early returns for him, very good to start this season. Interesting to see if he can keep up that torrid pace.
Yeah, when you talk about averaging 100 yards a game as a receiver, extrapolate that over 16 games, and you're having a monster season. So, yeah, you love what he's doing early, but I think it's got to go back to the offseason, doesn't it? It's got to go back to the roots, spending time with the guys going to throw the ball to him, spending time watching tape, spending time reading defenses, and, of course, getting himself ready to play.
Across the 30 to the 31-yard line, 3 yards on the pickup. there, and it'll be second down. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have first half highlights and analysis.
LR, plenty to show in this one.
Going to be a busy man at intermission. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
An update from Buffalo. The Bills have now opened up a 2-touchdown lead. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. So here we go, first and 10 now.
Came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the play.
just better defense. I think you're right. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. This is third and 10.
Let's go! 3-19! Watching that body! Gone! 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 Watching that body! Body!
Off play action. Blocked. He rifles one that's intercepted. But it's Ha-Ha Clinton Dix with a pick. Getting set to go again on the offensive side. Randall Cobb works his way back onto the field. He has certainly made the most of his catches so far, both of them going for touchdowns here in half number one.
And we've never met a team that doesn't talk about getting off to a fast start and featuring guys that they want to have the ball already. We're seeing both of those coming to play.
There he goes, right side. And he's going to take it away. This half has been theirs. They've gone to the second quarter in Buffalo. The Bills have taken the early lead. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, one touchdown pass into the end zone. Now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. But Charles, it's the second quarter. Your team's losing. You're not playing well as a quarterback, but like I said, it's the second quarter, so how worried are you?
You're concerned, but you're not panicked because you know there's still an opportunity. No one's excited about a stat line right now. One touchdown pass. Okay, that's cool. They're still an interception as well. Can you eliminate the mistakes and keep making the positive plays, the good plays? That's what they're looking for.
Time to find out if he can do just that.
Let's face it, you want to get back into the game. These are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss.
Hurry up, here we go. Gone, 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 gone.
Off the play fake. Brock. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
Draft the fastest, you can draft the most athletic guys, but if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, he'll force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. A little bit of tough catch, though, falls incomplete. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with a And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week three matchup. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Jimmy Garoppolo and his offense heading back. And Charles, he's already north of 300 yards in this game.
And while watching him work, I just keep coming back to what a magic number that is. We've almost made it routine, haven't we? 300 yards, wow, what a great day. We don't understand what goes into that. And today, he's taking advantage of every opportunity, and he's being very precise throwing the ball. After a play like that.
This will be fielded at the 8. He gets away from one. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
No. Check. Patriot.
Right, here we go.
Patriot.
Green, 39.
Back looks like the defense in press coverage here. That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Still second down.
No. Check. Patriot. Hurry up. Here we go. Green. All right, now. Lucky 56.
Let's go.
All right, now. Lucky 56. Watch it now. Barney.
Check.
Green.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. Found a little room there as he plays out to about the 37. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard.
They've been running it well all game, and why not? The big guys up front, they're just having a ball, creating monster holes for their guys to run through.
The Rams on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation.
All right, here we go.
They'll run again with Pumphrey. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
Another down on the scoreboard, but the urge to go for it is almost irresistible here on 4th and short.
Yeah, I know. I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
Up to the 47. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on 4th down.
To get to him and keep him short of the first.
Here we go now. 3-19. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
On 4th down. Brock. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And his defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. We've seen him do things like this all game.
It's not hard to figure out why they're down by that deficit. They haven't made plays that are going to keep them in the game or win the game all game long. That's another example right there. It all boils down at the end of it to execution. Either you make the play or you don't.
Now a handoff as they run left side. Was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's a 3rd quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where back now at Lambeau. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Running back, and he'll lose yardage here back at the 47. It's a long
loss of two. Now third down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Throwing his Garoppolo on third down. Looking left side of him, he's got a man. That's Horton.
Holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak?
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
They start on the ground with Pumphrey. He takes this for 3 to the 29.
Not much happening there on first down.
Thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion.
Detroit! Leopard! Here we go!
Looking to throw. Cross. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right? Safety valve.
No.
Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch. Second down now after the pass completion. Of a new set of downs.
What tight end? Hey, we got four.
Now let's go. Blue landing. Over. Watch it now, Barney.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Best coverage look defensively. Back to throw. Block. That's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Green 39!
Gone!
All right, here we go.
No.
Off the bootleg. is averted. Almost picked. Instead, second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here. That looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Before they're inside of the 25. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
All right, here we go.
Just a one-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make this a second down. Oh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Defensively to hold him to four, and now it's second and goal.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss it open field.
Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as it comes with exactly a minute to go in the football game. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
Set! Boom! Over! 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 Leopard! Leopard! Detroit! Detroit!
Looking to throw on second down. And now running right through it. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
And that's why defenders are often frustrated offensive guys. Actually made the catch, looked good doing it, but couldn't get his feet down in order to finish off the takeaway. Interception would have killed off the drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
Maybe one final chance here to make this a bit more respectable as they'll go for it on fourth and goal. It up only to about the six. 3 yards. yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college, and how about in the NFL? The miracle at the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take the knee. The game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And they'll get him down up past the 15. The Charles, it's one thing.